guys, my name is Joy, and I just wanted to hop on here to record a little video for you all about something I learned along with my little lettuce plant. Do you see how cute he is? His name is Robbie, and he sits on the sink where I do the dishes, and he just makes me so happy. He grows so fast, and 2 weeks ago, we cut off him. That's bad grammar. And we ate him for dinner, and that sounds mean, but then I put him in the water, and already within 2 weeks he has grown this tall. I've been shocked. And as I was watching him grow a couple weeks ago, I was just pondering about how much our lives are like this lettuce plant. When we go through something difficult, it's like it cuts us down to the stump. And we have such a choice at that moment, whether we're going to remain a stump or whether we're going to get in the water. To remain a stump is kind of like to hold on to the feelings that we have. Recently I went through something difficult and I really felt like I wanted to just keep to myself, and I didn't want to find the joy in the moment. I didn't want to find that gratefulness, and I didn't want to let go of the feelings that I had, and they were like feelings of resentment or bitterness. But it wasn't until I came to Christ humbly and asked him what his perspective was, and that he showed me that he was right there with open arms, just ready to turn my situation out for good, that I came to him and then repented of that. And I asked him to make it turn out beautiful, and already he has been doing that. But we have to choose to let go of those feelings, and we have to choose to come to Christ. Right now with the coronavirus especially, I've heard so many times of people saying, it's all gonna be okay. We have hope, and hope is such a big word right now. And everyone is saying it, and everyone says, we have hope. But truly, ponder, what is that hope based in? Why do we have hope? Is it more like a wish or a dream, or, yeah, I hope it'll work out? Or is it confidence? Can we have confidence? And we can have confidence, because there is one that is stable, and he's sufficient, and he is always there, and he's full. And that's Christ. And Christ is ready for us. And as soon as we bring our trials and our burdens and the things that are bothering us and going through, we bring them to him and we abide in that hope that he gives us. When we put our trust in him as the true hope giver, that the only one that can make situations turn out for good, then it's like putting this lettuce plant into the water. Immediately, he has the freedom to start working with our situation and bringing it together for good. And you know what's so cool is that he is 100% powerful, more powerful than any other thing on the earth or in the whole entire universe or the whole spiritual realm. He is the most powerful. And so nothing is out of his control. He can take whatever situation we're going through and he can make it beautiful. In Ecclesiastes 3:11, it says that he, God, has made all things beautiful in its time. And we just need to trust that. So I just want to encourage you all that if you're going through something right now, or if you know of someone that's going through something, encourage them to get into the water, which is Christ. Put their trust in Christ. Acknowledge that he is the one true source of hope, and he is the life giver. And I promise, I'm 100% guaranteed that when we do that, when we put our hope in Christ, he will cause new growth to come out of that situation. So, bye.